Hello everyone. Today I'm going to share a review paper about the genetic basis underlying plant-mediated cry for help to the microbiota. It is published in the iMeta journal. Plants are frequently facing diverse biotic and abiotic stresses, and increasing evidence suggests that stresses can induce drastic changes in the microbiota. However, whether and how plants positively shape a beneficial microbiota in response to stresses is still largely unknown. Understanding how plants recruit beneficial microbes is essential to the application of beneficial microbes in agriculture. In the first part of the review paper, we review the current understanding of how plants regulate microbiota changes in response to stresses, and the potential beneficial effect of the shifted microbiota. It is different from the chronic stress-responsive pathways, such as stress-responsive hormone signaling and the immune receptor pathways. So during the plant microbiota studies, it is technically difficult to confirm the causal link between microbiota changes and host phenotypes due to the super complexity of microbial communities. For instance, if we had a mutant enhanced the abundance of beneficial microbial pseudomonas in the rhizosphere, we want to know the potential effect or the potential benefits of this shifted microbiota. In our previous study, we designed a plant microbiota transplanting system which grows Y-type and the mutant plants in the natural soil as the first generation, and then remove the shoots and regrow Y-type plants as the second generation plants. We saw a significant increase in the fresh rate when in the presence of a microbiota from the mutant, which suggests the enriched pseudomonas or the shifted microbiota is beneficial to the next generation. And one step further, we found that the abundance of beneficial pseudomonas in the rhizosphere is correlated with the fresh rate or the growth promotion effect in the second generation. Another typical study is using synthetic community to confirm the link. A previous study found an immune-compromised mutant causing drastic shift in the microbiota and also the cell death phenotype in leaf. They isolated strains from the endosphere of Y-type and the mutant, and then they constructed a syncome from Y-type plants and the mutant. They inoculate Y-type plants in germ-free conditions and found that the syncome from the mutant background causing cell death in Y-type plants in the germ-free environment, which confirms the causal link between microbiota changes and cell death. In this, the second part of this review, we review the practical approaches linking microbiota changes and plant performance. We can first quantify the abundance of specific OTUs or strains, and if we see a correlation with plant traits, it provides preliminary correlation for us. And then we can use microbiota transplanting to confirm the potential link, and eventually using the microbiome synthetic microbial community to confirm the syncome from different plants or different treatments has different effects on the host. We can also use single strains from the syncome or strain recombination or deconstructed syncome to test the effect of specific strains on host performance. We propose that plants can cry for help to microbiota both upon biotic and abiotic stresses. And also, we propose that plants can dynamically shape microbiota in response to environment changes. So, if we use microbiota inoculation in agriculture, we should consider the timing of the treatment to get the highest beneficial to the host. Thanks for watching this video, and please keep an eye on the exciting